from the Northeast Georgia Business Radio X studio. Welcome to Time Has Come Today podcast series, where today's ideas become tomorrow's community. Presented by Beatland Records. Let every groove find a beat. All right, thank you guys for tuning in to Time Has Come Today podcast. Thank you, Tom, for producing as always. And Tom, I noticed that you were noticeably absent from State and Porch Fest last week.
Well, Tim, good to see you too, sir. Wow, he's right into me all of a sudden.
Yes.
Well, it's good to see you back in the Northeast studio. I have to say that.
It's a great studio. It is a really, nice studio.
What were you talking about?
State and Porch Fest. How
was
last
it?
Week? You know, it was great. It was really good for the first year.
It was rocking.
Yeah.
Or something.
It was rocking. There were some pretty good, really good bands, really good talent out there.
No massive fights and stuff like that. No brawls.
Fortunately, nothing like that. Nope.
Okay, well, that's good.
So
you're saying it wasn't in Winder. Is that what you're saying? I had to get that in there for our Winder friends. We have a lot of Winder friends. We love Winder.
Yes, of course.
But it's no Statham. Yes. It's no Statham. I have one of the grandest excuses. Other than with the exception of a funeral or a wedding, it depends how you look at that. It was my anniversary weekend, sir.
Wow.
So you couldn't get me in trouble with the redhead. I do that well myself.
So having a wedding anniversary keeps you from going out and seeing entertainment and being entertained?
She did not feel like driving for an hour to Statham, and I apologize for that.
Okay.
I guess. Well, I'm not really apologizing, but that is true. It was anniversary weekend.
Well, happy anniversary.
Well, I appreciate that.
And this was number six, right?
It was.
Well, cheers to that.
There's
cheers
a woman that has put up with me for at least 6 years. I know that's what you're all thinking.
That's right. And, well, here's to at least six more, right?
I hope so. What have you heard?
I'm not saying. I'm not allowed to say.
You're not allowed to say. You're scared of the redhead, too, and you've never met her. Or have
I've never.
You?
No, I've never met her.
Great. Jacqueline and I have been together forever, though, so...
That's awesome.
6 years legally, I guess. I don't know.
Yeah, well, that's great.
But congratulations on Porch Fest.
Well, thank you. Thank you. And speaking of Statham, on October 26th, we have Boo on Broad 5K. And we have I have a couple of great guests to talk about it. First off, Emily Dixon, welcome to the podcast. How are you doing?
I'm great, Tim. Thank you for having me.
You're originally from Winder, is that correct?
Yes, sir. Born and bred. I was a Barrow County native all my life and came back here to teach.
Wow, that's awesome. And how long have you been? You're at Statham Elementary.
Yes, sir. I've been at Statham for 9 years, 12 years total. Been at Statham Elementary for 9 years now. My dad went to Statham as a kid. And so my first classroom there was his fourth grade classroom.
Wow. It wasn't still a high school when he went through, was it?
No, it was an elementary school. When my grandpa was there, it was a high school.
So you have a whole lineage from Statham Elementary, right?
I sure do.
Wow.
I sure do.
That's wild. I didn't know that about your dad and granddad. Wow. Yeah. What grade would you teach?
I teach kindergarten. All 12 years of my teaching career has been in kindergarten. And one of the reasons I'm here today is I also help with our 4th and 5th grade writing club, which has brought me to you.
Awesome. That's great. We'll get back to that in a second. Right. My other guest, Angela Yarman, how are you doing?
I'm well. Thank you. How are you?
Doing great. And you are the director of the Barrow Community Foundation?
That's right.
How long have you been?
Not very long. I'm pretty new in town in Winder in Barrow County. I started with the Community Foundation in February.
Oh, wow. How is everything going? I mean, I know it's obviously a very trying time right now, but what is your experience? How's everything?
So I think a lot of people know the Barrow Community Foundation from some of the projects that we've done in the past, like the Winder Legacy Park. That's a project that the Barrow Community Foundation helped organize with the school system and the city of Winder and some other partners, and mainly local private donors provided the funding for that park. And it was a function of the foundation. Folks who put that together raised a little over $5 million.
Wow.
To build that park. That's been the focus of our activities for the last several years. But since the park did so well and we had sort of gained some momentum for the foundation, the board members decided now that the park is finished, or at least this phase of it is finished, that we should move forward with trying to promote the foundation for the more traditional purposes of a community foundation, which is fund holding and grant making, which we had not really been involved in the past. We have a few endowed scholarships, but other than that, we don't have any donor advised funds and those kinds of things that that community foundations typically have. So that's our goal. We've been trying to organize since I came on board in February to get ready to do that. And then, of course, we've been interrupted by the crisis.
Right.
So that's kind of where we are.
CFIT, is that the same as the park?
Yes, it's the Winder Legacy Park. That's what the name has been officially designated for the park. But for a long time, people around Barrow County knew it as CFIT Park,
right,
because it's on the CFIT campus. But it actually has its own official name now, and it's Winder Legacy Park.
And there's more to be added to it, right? Is this just a phase one,
yes,
that's been open?
So what has happened in phase one, and the part that people don't really see about the park, is that a lot of the money was spent on things like design work and engineering and grading and drainage and sidewalks and those kinds of things. So a lot of that sort of infrastructure is in place and is ready now for us to add the other elements of the park. But we've started as far as the attractions at the park, the big community playground, which is fantastic. It has a 28-foot rope climbing pyramid, which is
nice,
pretty unique in the United States.
Yeah.
Not the only one, but one of the first that has sort of caught on in the United States. And a lot of other great features that are ADA accessible and appeal to all ages and all abilities. So we're really proud of the playground. It's the Philip and Shelley Gosling playground. They were the major benefactors on that part of it. And then we have a 1/3 mile concrete walking trail that goes around an event field that is the Republic Services field.
Oh, that's great.
And so those are the two main things that are in place right now. But in the future, there will be several other elements. And we're looking forward to raising some more money and being able to put those in place.
Now, have you climbed to the top of Barrosaurus?
No, I admire people who want to do that, but I will not be among them.
Is it true a splash pad is coming?
A splash pad is in the major plan. We don't know when we'll be able to add that. There are a lot of complicated issues around a splash pad. So we're working with our partners to determine when we might be able to add that. But splash pad is one of the things that people are really excited about, and we hope to be able to bring that about soon. There are also plans for a dog park and some sports courts like basketball goals and that sort of thing. There's a tree house in the plan, a food court circle. We've got reading nooks coming and just lots of great fun things for families and kids to do. So we'll see what gets on the list first and what gets built first, but all of those things are part of the grand plan.
Wow.
That's awesome.
That's
looking forward to those things developing.
Well, that's great for Winder. Now back to Statham.
Right. Well, it's a park for all of Barrow County,
right,
and we want everybody to come and enjoy it. And people have been. The park is crowded all the time.
Yeah. That's great. The Community Crisis Fund was started after the tragedy at Appalachia High School. Is that correct?
Yes, it was. We established that fund on the day of the incident.
Okay.
And mainly because we wanted to provide a way. We knew that there would be donors from all over the country who would want to help. A lot of times those kinds of donors are corporations and foundations and other nonprofits. They want to have a good place to send their contributions and know that they're going to be properly stewarded and invested properly and taken care of. That's a typical role of a community foundation in a crisis in a community. You're seeing now with Hurricane Helene,
right,
there are community foundations down in Augusta and Macon who have activated crisis funds for those things. So it's a typical thing for community foundations to do. But because we were in this sort of state of restructuring, we had to really put our efforts together to try to get it launched. But we launched it the very first day of the incident, and we began receiving online contributions from local people and people all over the state and all over the country that same day. And then we launched our effort to reach out to some of the bigger companies and corporations, and that's where a lot of the money has come from. We've raised almost $100,000 from online donations from local people, and the rest of it has come from all over the country.
Wow, that's great. All right, so Emily, this will be the third year of the BOO. All 3 years we have split the money between Statham Elementary School and Bear Creek Middle School. As far as the running club at Statham Elementary School, how have those funds helped your running club?
Each year, all the participants that have majority attendance for running club, so that's fall and spring, the participants get a very nice t-shirt, and kids will work for anything for a t-shirt. They love to come out to running club, and just because they know at the end of the year they're going to get a t-shirt that says they participated in running club. And we give them all running club shirts. We give them medals at the end of the year. Of course, we do popsicles too because they're kids. This year, we're looking into starting for the next school year an actual running program for kids to help them. The goal is 100 miles in a year.
Wow.
And so we're looking into using some of those funds to help cover kids that might be able to afford it.
Right.
But that'll be for next school year.
Right. That's great. And you said it's only 4th and 5th that participate?
Yes. So we have about 20 4th graders and about 20 5th graders that participate each week.
Have you noticed their attendance improves, their grades improve? What have you seen in the...
It's one of those like good accountability things, and especially for kids that struggle with their behavior because of hyperactivity,
right.
This gives them a productive outlet. And so we've seen kids that were behavior issues before kind of dwindle out their behaviors in the school, because we can also say, hey, you can't behave at school, you can't stay for running club.
Oh, that's good.
It's a good motivator for these kids.
Right. Oh, that's great.
And then also, because it is just 4th and 5th, you have even kindergartners that are like, I want to be in 4th and 5th grade, wow, so I can do running club. And so it's come to fruition now that I've had one kid that was in kindergarten with me. He's now a 4th grader, and every year he's like, is it my year? This is his year. And he was so excited. And it's the best outlet for him.
How many years have you been doing the running club since you started?
Since I started. Yes, I was originally just like a little volunteer, and now I'm officially a co-coach with Dr. Deloach.
Okay. Have you noticed, though, since you've been in it for that many years, have you noticed them going on to either middle school or high school and continue running?
Absolutely. Just this past year, we had a 5th grader move up to the middle school cross-country team, and he's thriving. So it's fun to see, because a lot of our kids, they also do baseball and football and other sports, soccer, and whatnot. And so we say we're helping condition them for that as well. So
that's great.
It's fun to see the athleticism.
And where have the funds from the Boo gone to? I know we did we cleaned up the trails behind the school over the summer.
So it bought a lot of dirt, as you know. Honestly, we need some more. That's going to come soon. But it also helped pay for the tractor that we used to lay out the land and some of the tools. But a lot of the shirt money came from that too, and then the medals and stuff.
That's great. Are kids generally excited about the Boo coming up? Do they mostly do the 1K? Do they participate in the 5K?
A lot of them do the 1K just because they don't think they have the stamina to do a 5K, even though I'm like, you can walk it, you can know run it. But having some kids that are from state on that have been to the Boo before, they are helping motivate kids that they can do a 5K.
Right. Oh, that's great.
So we passed out the registration forms at Running Club the other day. Hopefully we'll get some registered.
And then dressing up in costumes always helps, right?
Absolutely. And for myself included, I've already got my costume planned.
What is it this year?
We are being Wizard of Oz.
Oh, wow.
So I'm the Scarecrow.
So you and Mrs. Cash?
Yes, we got Miss Cash and then Miss Waller and Miss King coming so far. And then, of course, my husband and two little girls, Dorothy.
And you're the Scarecrow, huh?
Yes.
Do you think that hay is going to stay in there for 3 miles?
Well, thankfully, it's a poncho. It's not as itchy.
Gotcha.
I try to actually run the 5K, too. That'd be horrible, all the itchy.
Ugh. Right.
Yes, I got a headband. But the costumes are winners for these kids.
Yeah, that's great.
That's fun.
It is a lot of fun. It's a lot of fun to see them out running them.
Oh, yeah. So, and thankfully, Stadium's a rather flat course, too.
Yeah. All right. All right, ladies, we're going to take a quick break. We'll be right back.
Vinyl lovers, it's time to spin something new. Welcome to Beatland Records, your one-stop shop for all things vinyl. From timeless classics to the latest hits, we've got an incredible selection to suit every taste. Browse through our easy-to-use website and discover hidden gems, exclusive releases, and everything in between. Our fast shipping and secure packaging will make your record safe, sound, and ready to play. Whether you're a seasoned collector or just getting started, Beatland Records brings the record store experience right to your door. So why wait? Drop the needle on something fantastic today. Visit BeatlandRecords.com now and let the music play.
All right, welcome back to Time Has Come Today podcast. Tom, are you a... are you a runner?
No, God, no.
So your dad was a Navy DI. He didn't have you up at 0500 running wind sprints?
No, no, gosh, no. He was retired by the time I come around.
Oh, okay.
He was still mean as whatever you can fill in the blank there, but no, he never did. He never did. He just told me how slow I was. You know, and that didn't really help.
Lovely.
No, not a runner to this day, not a runner. I can destroy an elliptical like no tomorrow, but running, no.
Yeah.
No. I have very old man knees.
Hey, you can walk a 5K, just so you know.
Yeah, ain't happening.
Tried there, Tim.
No. If you can somehow do a 5K elliptical thing
right
from my home gym, I'm all over it.
We could do like a virtual boo.
I think you should. Run the... Yes, the virtual boo.
And we could, you know, I'm just reminding you, this isn't your anniversary weekend again on the 26th.
No, it's not. But
so you don't have an out.
But I am. But I do. I always have an out. I am emceeing a car show.
Oh, no baseball?
No. Baseball season's over, I guess.
Oh, okay.
Maybe next spring they'll let me back in the booth. You never can tell with those people.
Yeah.
Anyway.
All right. Well, we'll catch you on the elliptical then.
I got to get back to producing. You know, important right. things, you know.
That's right. Thank you guys for sticking around. I appreciate it. If you're still sticking around. Thank you. So, Angela, for the Community Crisis Fund, this was started the day that the incident happened, the tragedy happened. How long will it be available? How long is it open?
So we have designated the fund through June of 2025. We'll keep it open that long so that every contribution that comes in between now and then will be designated specifically for recovery from the Appalachia crisis. If we're still receiving funds after that, we'll extend that period. But the crisis fund has a broader purpose than just one particular crisis. It'll be open from now on to deal with any crisis that might happen in Barrow County. And so we put parameters on the time period so that we can designate the money specifically for certain activities during certain time periods.
How does the Appalachia community access the funds?
That's one thing that's been very interesting about our grant process. As a community foundation specifically, and as a nonprofit in general, when we receive a donation, it is tax deductible. And that causes us to be subject to some very specific state and federal laws and IRS regulations that require us to invest the dollars that we receive in what they call a qualified charitable purpose. That's a legal definition.
Okay.
And that means that we cannot provide this funding directly to individuals, and we can't provide it to any kind of for-profit business. So all of the money that we are receiving has to be granted out to nonprofit organizations and government agencies. Those are qualified as qualified charitable purposes. We're looking for the nonprofit community and some of the government agencies, including the school system itself and the school itself and the sheriff's department and whoever else is serving a role in the recovery. They'll be applying for the money, and then they'll be using it to provide direct services to people who have needs.
I see. So you guys have a board that votes on, decides who gets what, how much?
Yes. So we have our regular foundation board of directors that guides our work all through the year. But then we've also established a specific committee just for this crisis fund, and we've pulled together people that we believe are experts on the subject. So it's people who are directly involved in the recovery, people from the school system, from the school, from the sheriff's office, from the medical community, from the churches, people who really have their finger on the pulse of what is happening in the Appalachia community and the needs of the people. And so that is going to help us set the priorities for which applications get funded and which ones get funded first and which ones get funded the most and where the needs are the greatest. And so we know that we'll have applications from all sorts of organizations who have great ideas, and we won't have enough money to fund all of them.
I see.
And so we'll have to pick and choose based on what our panel of experts believe are the most important things.
Have you received applications yet?
Yes, we have a grant window open now.
Okay.
We opened the first grant window on September 30th, which is lightning fast. That is just 3 weeks after the incident. Mm-hmm. And the reason it took 3 weeks to open a grant window is because it took that much time for us to actually get any money in the bank. We had some online donations that were coming in, but most of the corporations and foundations, even the ones that called us on the first day, it took them 3 weeks to get their check processed and for us to receive it in the mail and get it in the bank. So we just had enough money to open a grant window 3 weeks later. And so as soon as we had enough money, immediately we have opened that grant window. The formula that we're using for each grant round is the amount of money that we have cash on hand. We're going to distribute 50% of that in each grant round. And the idea behind that is we know there will be some long-term needs. We don't want to run out of money before we see what those needs are. So we'll be distributing 50% of the funds that we have on hand at each time that we open a grant window. So for right now, this grant window is opened on September 30th.
Right.
The grant application deadline is October 15th, and then the committee will meet the following week and make the determinations, and then that money will go right out. It's going pretty quick.
I see. And then there'll be another grant window open.
There'll be another grant window that will open October 30th.
Okay.
The deadline for that will be November the 15th. So we're going to do a grant window about every 30 to 60 days.
I see.
We may not have it go during the holidays. We may wait until January. One right after the other is what we plan to do until all of the funds are expended.
That's great. That's some good information. Are you going to come out to the Boo?
I would love to. Ooh, awesome. Yay.
Are you a runner?
I'm a walker.
Awesome.
I've walked
yes.
5Ks in the past.
Fantastic.
And they're lots of fun. And yeah. I've actually put on 5Ks with some of the other organizations that I worked with
right.
in my past career. And I love to see, fast runners are great. And you
right.
love to see somebody come across the finish line in just a few minutes. And that's always very exciting.
Right.
But I love to see people come out with a baby stroller,
yeah.
you know, and just really make,
we have those.
Make a fun day out of it for their family and not be worried that they're yeah. the last one in the line and the sheriff's,
yep.
sheriff's car's right behind
right.
them. Just like, oh, here we go.
Yeah.
That's one thing I do love about the Boot Run is that you do have that climate. It's not,
yes.
I mean, you have your fast ones, of course, but right. you also have all the ones in costumes because people wear costumes that
yes.
are hard to run in.
Yes.
Yeah.
So it's more about the costume.
Yeah.
And that's just tons of fun.
Yes.
It's a 5K is something that even little kids can do. People in all levels of fitness can do. And it's just a great way to raise money for a good cause.
Baby strollers. We have the dog walkers. It is a lot of fun. And mm-hmm. There's young elementary school kids, so it's a lot of walking. It's good. It's safe. The majority of the houses have their Halloween decorations out. A lot of people are out in the costumes. Do you have a costume picked out?
I'll have to think about that a little bit. I'll come up with a good one.
Can't wait to see it. What's your costume, Tim?
You know, I don't know. As the race director, I don't usually where I might do, I don't know, I'll come up with something this year, Abe Lincoln or something. I'll
Ooh,
come up with something.
That sounds
like
good.
Hey, Tim, I'll do the Boo if you push me in a stroller.
You're on.
I can provide a
Sweet.
Stroller for you.
Now
I'm a big kid, so be careful.
Now, are you going to be wearing Depends? You can be wearing diapers?
I'm not
I
that
can
old,
push
man.
You around in?
I'm not. You're older than me. Not by much, but you are.
You got the old knees. I didn't know.
I do have the old knees.
I didn't know
knees.
If everything else was old. I don't
Call
know.
Call them a bag of chips, Bill. I'm sorry.
Yes, we also have costume contests. We have individual winners, and then we also have groups like four or five or more.
For that group one, Tim.
Yeah. We have a DJ. We have a great DJ commish will be out. It's a lot of fun. It's a great atmosphere and a lot of fun. So set your calendar, October 26th. Runtheboo.com is our website. Boo on Broad is our Facebook page, and there's an event on there. Angela, do you have a website?
Yes. All the information that we have about the Crisis Fund is on our website, which is BarrowCF, like Community Foundation, BarrowCF.org. And then right on that front page, there's a button that says Appalachia Recovery, and that takes you to our Crisis Fund page. That has all the frequently asked questions. When we're getting questions from the community, we're posting them, we're answering them there. That page gets updated as we develop more information or as we get asked other great questions. Our donate button is also there. We've
Fantastic.
Had over 500 people, local people, well, people from all over the country, but including local people, make contributions between $10 and $100 on that donate
wow.
button. And that has added up to close to $100,000. Every gift makes an impact and helps us meet the needs of this crisis. And we're very
That's
grateful
great.
For all of it.
Companies and corporations can also go to the same place. They
yes.
can donate through the same
They can donate. Most of them don't donate through the button. They call us and
oh,
tell
okay.
us that they intend to make a contribution, and then there's usually some paperwork that we have to complete. So we usually know that a large contribution is on the way. We just don't really know when we're going to get
gotcha.
It until it gets here.
Okay.
We don't count it until it gets here.
Right.
You can visit Statham Elementary School's Facebook page and Instagram, see all of our upcoming events. We have book fair and all those things coming up. So
you got a fall festival next
and
week,
And we do
right?
have a fall festival, yes. I'll be in the Duncan booth, so it's going to be fun.
Duncan booth in middle of October?
It's chilly.
Wow.
I'm the first one to go, though, so it's for the kids.
That's going to be a lot
like
of fun.
Yes, yeah.
Give a shout-out to Casto's Trading Company in Statham. Wade Casto has been a longtime supporter of the Boo. He is in North Carolina. They are on the corner of 2nd and Railroad Street in Statham. Great hardware store. Great folks. Always involved with the community. I guess that wraps it up. Thank you so much for listening. Time has come today. And this is sponsored by Beadland Records, where every groove finds a beat. I'm Tim Terilli, and we'll see you on the porch in Statham.